Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our devotion and prayer time for this Thursday. We are in Acts chapter 7. Excuse me. Acts chapter 17, beginning at verse 18. Paul is in Athens, and he is doing some major debating, if you will, concerning the gospel and concerning the cause of Christ. We pick up in verse 18, and the Bible says, "He, Paul, also had a debate with some of the Epicurean and Stoic philosophers. When he told them about Jesus and his resurrection, they said, 'What is this babbler trying to say with these strange ideas he's picked up?' Others said, 'He seems to be preaching about some foreign gods.' Then they took him to the high council of the city. 'Come and tell us about this new teaching,' they said. 'You are saying some rather strange things, and we want to know what it's all about.' It should be explained that all the Athenians, as well as the foreigners in Athens, seem to spend all their time discussing the latest ideas. So Paul, standing before the council, addressed them as follows: 'Men of Athens, I notice that you are very religious in every way. For as I was walking along, I saw your many shrines, and one of your altars had this inscription on it: "To an unknown God." This God, whom you worship without knowing, is the one I'm telling you about. He is the God who made the world and everything in it. Since he is Lord of heaven and earth, he doesn't live in man-made temples, and human hands can't serve his needs, for he has no needs. He himself gives life and breath to everything, and he satisfies every need. From one man, he created all the nations throughout the whole earth. He decided beforehand when they should rise and fall, and he determined their boundaries." So we're going to stop right there at verse 26. This is an epic portion of scripture, if you will, as Paul is debating with these Greeks who, as we know throughout history, were very intelligent, very learned, and they sought to understand things. And as Paul was going through the city, he noticed all of these idols and monuments to different gods. And he comes across this one that says, "To an unknown God." And the Holy Spirit uses that phrase in Paul to speak to them and help them to understand who exactly that was. And of course, he goes on to explain in great detail that it was God himself, the one true God who made heaven and earth and who created everything. But here's the key to this for those believers, those that would come to Christ, and to everyone today and who has ever lived. There is the image of the unknown God within each one of us. There is a space within each one of us for that unknown God. And we know who that unknown God is. He is not unknown. He is known. He is just waiting for us to invite him in. You see, he desires nothing more than to be known by his creation. He wants us to say yes to him. That's what Paul was trying to get these Greek philosophers and deep thinkers, if you will, to understand that that's what God wanted, that he wanted to be known by them. And so Paul does all this reasoning and debating to convince them to understand what the message of the gospel is all about. And this comes back to what we've talked about many times, understanding our audience. You see, Paul talked to the people in the synagogue, the learned Jewish people, in one way. And then when he went to the Greeks, he was able to talk to them in another way. He understood his audience and was able to share the gospel with them because of that. And that is what we need to understand. Understand our audience. If we're talking to children, we got to understand where they're coming from. If we're talking to teenagers, a whole different creature. We got to understand where they're coming from. If we're talking to middle-aged adults, we've got to understand that. If we're talking to senior citizens, we've got to understand the life experiences that they've had and what they've gone through. This is what Paul did, and this is the example that we have from him. So let us, once again today, strive to be sensitive to those around us and to understand where they are coming from. And as we share the love of God with them, let's just pray that the Holy Spirit will open their hearts and open their minds, that they will see that the most important thing in their life, it's not their job, it's not their finances, it's not all their activities. The most important thing in their life is their relationship with God. He desires that. He desires to know them. He desires to know us. And he's just waiting for us to say yes to him. So let that be our challenge today. Father God, we come to you this morning in the name of Jesus. And we pray, Father, that just as Paul did, we will be aware of what's going on around us. We'll be aware of those that we're talking to. We'll be aware of those that you bring into our lives. And you will give us the ability, through the power of the Holy Spirit working in us and through us, to meet people right where they are. As Paul did, have an intellectual conversation, if that's necessary, to have a emotion-based conversation, if that's what's necessary, if it's simply just to love on somebody through Jesus, let that be what we do today, Father. Speak to each one of us today. Fill us with your Spirit, we pray, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Well, I trust you'll have a wonderful Thursday. And until tomorrow, may the Lord, as always, bless you and keep you. May his face shine upon you. May he be gracious to you, and may he give you peace. And may you fall just a little bit deeper in love with Jesus today. Take care. God bless you.